what's going on, guys. Hopefully you guys are safe and sound, away from all this craziness that's in our world right now. And tonight I want to talk about the election. And the reason why I want to talk about it is because so many people are confused. So many people are scared. So many people, and rightfully so, because the media is not helping with this. Media is making it worse. If you go to one channel, it says one thing. You go to another channel, it says the other thing. There is just so much real information, but disinformation. And I do feel like the different media channels and news outlets are making it very hard to figure out which one is which. The fact that we could have two realities going on right now, because that's what's happening. We have one reality where Biden wins and he's the president. We have one reality where Donald Trump wins and he's the president, based on, you know, like election fraud. So it's like you go, what the fuck is going on here? Like, there can only be one truth, right? So what the fuck is going on? Now, bear with me. So there's been a lot of, it's just confusion in the mainstream media about these different lawsuits and this stuff that are filed. And, you know, people like, that's it. Biden won. Donald Trump's lawsuit was thrown out of court. And I mean, you read all these things and the way they're presented to you, they read a certain way, but they're not accurate. Now, let me explain. So I had a few people be like, oh, you know, Jerry, Donald Trump's things got thrown out of court. And what's interesting was Donald Trump hadn't even been to court yet. So his team had actually not even been to court. This was things that were filed from other people, different senators, different congressmen. There was all kinds of people that were filing stuff. And some of those things were getting thrown out, but they were being reported on mainstream media as Donald Trump's team. Now, are they Republicans? Yes, but they're not Donald Trump's legal team. Like, it's not Giuliani and Sidney Powell and them getting thrown out. Like, that's not what it is. They hadn't even submitted their information and their proof, their evidence, to the court yet. So that happened today in Pennsylvania. Now, I want to make sure that, like, by the time I'm done with this, you at least go out on your own and you really research what's going on. And I don't mean like you go to the news and see what's happening now. I mean, really go research the Constitution and things that you may not really know very well, or laws, or, you know, whatever you're not understanding. Go study that stuff, because it's only been a year that I've been doing this stuff. And it's really, I wouldn't say it's hard to understand. It's actually pretty easy to understand, but you have to have all the information. You have to have it all in front of you. You can't listen to somebody giving you a piece of it and not giving you all of it, because it doesn't make any sense and it's confusing. So here's the deal. I think a lot of people right now are waiting for these states like Pennsylvania, Michigan, Arizona, Georgia. They're waiting. Is it Arizona? Yes, it's Arizona. I think what that's happened is they're waiting for them to count up all these votes by hand, and then they're going to flip red for Trump, because they're going to find out the election fraud. That's how it worked. They basically gave the votes to Biden. They screwed Trump out of them, and Trump's going to win. And that's not what's going to happen, okay? That's not even remotely what's going to happen. Now, they are finding, and Fox News has reported, I saw something on NBC about it, which was kind of shocked, but they are reporting, mainstream media, not CNN, not CNBC, not the ones that usually really lean far left or radical left. They are reporting that there is voter fraud, and this is actual lawyers that are reporting this. People like Sidney Powell, people like Rudy Giuliani, real lawyers that are actually reporting it, that have gone to court, that are in court right now. Giuliani is actually in court right now. He's actually working the case in Pennsylvania. Now, these people are not going to court to try to get those states flipped red. Like, right now, that whole electoral votes, 270, that's not what this is about. I think people, they're constantly watching that 270, 270. Biden's got 270. Oh, no, he's got 245. Now he's got 250. Now he's down to 238. Trump's up to 212. Like, they're watching this electoral vote because they think that's going to be the end of it. Like, whoever hits 270, really, when you count up all the votes and get all the legal votes and get rid of all the illegal ones, that's who's going to be the president. That is not what's happening right now. They, meaning Trump's team, are actually going to court providing evidence that will then, even if it gets thrown out of court, what they're trying to do is get it pushed up to the Supreme Court. When they bring all this evidence, and they have hundreds of affidavits, they have sworn testimony, they have whistleblowers, they have people that have come forward that, you know, flat out they were involved with it, and they're just like, they're done. They're done with the bullshit, and they know if they get caught, because they're going to get caught, that they're going to fucking jail. Electoral fraud is not a fucking joke. People go to jail, do not pass go, do not collect $200, go right to jail, you stay there. Like, this is not a joke. Interfering with an election, you're fucked. So these people are coming forward in hopes to make a deal. They've been caught, but they have evidence, and they're just giving the evidence up because they don't want to go to jail. Like, they're trying to save themselves. So now here what you have is the age-old pile of evidence, and you have to bring that evidence and present it to the court and let the court decide whether or not that evidence is proper enough to make a ruling. Now, what is that ruling? Like, why are they going to the Supreme Court? Here's why. When you get to the Supreme Court, they don't have to prove who got 270 electoral votes. They don't have to prove who got the popular vote. They don't have to prove anything votes-wise, numbers-wise. The only thing they have to prove is the fact that electoral fraud took place. And this time, it was a massive scale, and it was caught. Now, the next thing is, after proving that, which they're going to be able to prove, they have all the proof. There's no way that they can't prove it. After that, now, who's to blame? They have to prove without a shadow of a doubt that, you know, I'm not going to say Biden did it, because I don't think he has the, I really don't think he has the brain to do it right now. You know what I mean? He doesn't have what it takes to pull off something like this. Now, is he involved? Yes, he's involved. But it's going to be his campaign or someone pulling the strings, which would be the DNC, whether it's the far left radical or just the Democrat, whatever you want to call it. It's radical now at this point. The Democratic Party will be the one that they're going to try to prove to get Biden into office, cheating the election. Now, here's the really crazy thing. All it takes is one fraudulent vote. One single fraudulent vote. And I don't mean like a mistake. I don't mean like, oh, they dropped a bag and it didn't get counted. I mean literally someone flipped a vote from Trump to, you know, Biden. Or someone took Trump's vote and tore it up and threw it out. Or someone started filling out, you know, ballots with Biden stuff and putting them in. Bringing in outside ballots in the middle of the night. All they have to do is prove one of those ballots is fraudulent. And that it came from the DNC. And that excludes, it disqualifies the DNC from the presidential race. Including whoever they decide to put up there. Meaning Biden, you know, if technically if Biden got caught, you can say, okay, Biden's disqualified. The DNC could replace him with somebody else and say, okay, well, this is our new candidate. When the DNC goes down for it, you can no longer have the candidate. You are disqualified from the race. President Trump will automatically win that election based on that. Now, this sounds crazy, but this is how it works. The Supreme Court is going to be ruling based on the evidence that they get by, I think it was December 14th or something like that. But make no mistake about it. This is not about electoral votes. This is not even about finding fraud. They already found it. They found it and it's out there and it is fucking huge. And they knew it was coming. They knew this was coming. They absolutely, I mean, whether you love Trump or hate Trump, I didn't vote. I don't have any fucking Trump flags or anything like that. But I did hear him all year long talking about electoral fraud. You know, there was a post from, I think, 2012 or something like that, where one of these machines that was used in this election that screwed everything up, screwed up the votes from Mitt Romney to Obama. Like, it flipped them. And they found out about it after the election. So they really couldn't do anything about it. It was a glitch that they supposedly had, which, you know, I don't know if it would have overturned the election or not, but it would have been the same case here if Obama and the DNC were the ones behind it and it was proven, then they would have been disqualified from the presidential candidacy. So there's a lot going on here, guys. And this really is, I mean, what a time to be alive. Like, we've never, ever seen anything like this. And what's crazy is you have these people from the DNC and all these other places, like these experts and people that have been involved in elections and stuff. And they're like, look, election fraud always takes place. And I'm like, what the fuck? They say it like it's just common knowledge. It's not a big deal. Yeah, election fraud always takes place. What? Like, if you know that, why aren't you taking precautions to stop it? Because it's still going on now. And now it's grown to the point where it's so big that there's so many facets to this. They couldn't even control them all. And that made it harder for them to hide what was going on. It was such a large-scale fraud that it made it easier for everyone to see and made a great paper trail for them to follow. You know, on top of it, the people that are coming out and just blatantly ratting them out. Like, there's so much going on right now, guys. And again, Biden is not the president-elect. I'm sorry. I know people are going to get pissed about it. It's not how it works. It's just not. You know, I don't care what the media says. Matter of fact, I went out and bought a bunch of newspapers that said Biden is the president. Because I'm like, look, if he is the president, that's great. He's a 46th president. And we had a crazy election and a crazy 2020. So that's a cool memento. But when this thing flips from Biden, and I don't mean the states flip, when they go to court and they prove what's happening because they have all the evidence, that's historical. That's historical that the media chose the electoral, the president-elect without any proper vetting, without any proof, without any certification. Like, it really makes you stop and think, like, what the fuck is going on? Like, we know for a fact that many of these, you know, CNN and stuff like that, they fuck things up all the time. They never even redact it. They just go on to the next thing. So, like, to even think that those people, like, were on the up and up all the time, like, I don't trust, and you don't even trust Fox. I don't trust any of them as far as I can fucking throw them. But the bottom line is, this is real. This is happening right now. And because the mainstream media is squashing it, you're not hearing a whole lot about it. But the problem is, it doesn't matter. In the end, the truth is going to come out. It's going to be in the Supreme fucking Court. If you don't think that that is going to be in the news, you cannot bypass the Supreme Court and act like it's not fucking happening. I don't care if you're CNN. I give a fuck who you are. Like, that shit is going to hit the news, and we're going to see real time what's really going on. But until then, mass confusion, you know, mass, you know, fights, arguments, battles, you know, riots. Like, these things are going to happen until then. We have two opposing sides that neither one of them wants to fucking go down. Neither one of them wants to give up. Neither one of them wants to lose. But the proof, like, that's all it is. It's about the proof. Get the proof, prove it in a court of law, and this whole thing turns into something we never thought we'd see in the beginning of 2020. Like, we knew that, hey, look, Donald Trump's been talking about election fraud for, you know, a year, 2 years, 10 years, whatever he's been doing, it's for a while. But now, it's so widespread, and there's so much proof, and so many people have come forward. Like, this is dirtier than we ever thought it was. Like, we saw this year, check this out. We saw dirty politicians, which is normal. We saw dirty cops. We saw dirty doctors. We saw, I mean, dirty nurses. We saw fucking dirty everything. Dirty teachers. You know, we saw people that we never, never would have known that these people were bad people in positions of power, manipulating things so that they get their just due and fuck everybody else. It doesn't really matter. It was about making money. It was about power. It was about control. And we never thought in a million fucking years we would see anything like that. I mean, the people were right around us the whole time. We had no idea. But that's where we are. And that's the truth. And I know there's a lot of people like, Jerry, you're fucking crazy. You're stupid. Look, everything I fucking have said the last 4 months has come true one at a time. Bing, bing, bing. And they've all popped true. And listen, I would love to be wrong. I would love to be wrong and say, hey, it's an easy election. Either Biden won or Trump won. Let's fucking wrap it up and let's move along. But that's not the facts. Like, the facts are, this is going on. And if you live around here in DC, like, the shit is hitting the fan. Like, it's very quiet here. It's very, like, creepy. It's, like, eerie to go outside and go anywhere around here because people are, they're on edge. Like, they are on edge. They are not sure what the fuck is going on. But I can tell you this right now. There isn't a single one here or anybody watching this that doesn't know for a fucking fact that some shady fucking shit went on in this election. And the whole thing is fucked, and someone is to blame. That someone is who we're going to find out. If it's Donald Trump, if it's Biden, if it's this one, if it's that one, we're going to find out. The problem is, you're going to have to take whatever prejudices you have towards the opposite side that you stand with, and we're going to have to decide. You know, we're going to have to see the truth. You're going to decide to see the truth. So in closing, guys, I hope you guys are doing well. Don't be scared. Don't be freaked out. This is the way it's supposed to go. Just take care of yourself. You know, watch yourself, watch your family, take care of yourself, and be well. I'll see you guys on the other side of this. I'm BioStream, and I approve this message. And we're out.